From this point forward, any laughter, any applause that you hear just helps you to relax that much more. This laughter and applause is for you, and it just helps you to want to perform even more. So let's give your stars a round of applause. This applause is for you. All right. Did we have some people in the audience?
Yeah, they're taken care of.
All right.
Good deal.
All right. Okay.
They know what to do.
Those of you who are on the stage and otherwise laying on the floor out in the gym, you notice that the weather is changing here in Washington. It's getting cold, and somebody has left the doors open in this building, and it is getting so cold. Oh my goodness, it's 30 degrees in this room, and you can feel that breeze. And if you feel a person next to you, you might just cuddle up to that person just so you can get that body heat. It is minus 10 degrees, and you will be careful. You will be careful about the edge of the stage, but it is minus 10 degrees in this room. It is so cold. Oh my goodness. It's minus 40 degrees in this room. It is so cold. Oh, that's right. The more you cuddle, the warmer you get. It feels so good to feel that body heat of that person next to you. Oh my goodness. It's minus 60 degrees in this room. You can feel the goosebumps on your arms, on your back, on your legs, on your toes, on your fingers. It is so cold. Oh, somebody realizes it and they shut the door and they turn the heat up. The temperature's just right. Ah, oh, it feels so good. The temperature's just right. The heat fills the room and it's getting hotter and hotter. It's 90 degrees in this room. It is so hot. It is so hot. Ladies, you will keep your clothes on. Ladies, you will keep your clothes on. It's 110 degrees in this room. It is absolutely so hot. It is horrible. It is so hot. It's 130 degrees in this room. The sweat is rolling down your forehead. It's going down the middle of your back. You're sweating between your toes. It's so hot in here. It's 180 degrees in this room. Oh my goodness. It is sweltering heat. It is the worst heat wave that's ever gone through the state of Washington. It is so hot. You're sweating everywhere. You can feel your clothes sticking to you. Oh my goodness. Somebody comes in and they turn the AC on. The temperature's just right. Ah, it feels just right. It is so nice. Then you realize something else. With all the sweating that's been going on, the person next to you has the worst BO you have ever smelt in your life. It is absolutely nasty. It's the worst smell you have ever smelled. It smells like a skunk. Now, you won't throw up, but it is absolutely the worst smell you have ever smelt in your entire life. Oh my goodness. How could anybody go out in public smelling that bad? Oh my goodness. It is absolutely disgusting, the smell. Then you realize something else. Then you realize something else, being very careful at the edge of the stage. You realize something else. It's not the person next to you that smells, it's you. You have come out in public smelling like a skunk, and you are with all of your peers here tonight, and you smell like a skunk. And then you realize something else. You smell bad, but the person next to you is getting blamed for it, and that just becomes absolutely hilarious. Becomes the funniest thing you've ever thought of, that you could smell this bad and the person next to you is getting blamed for it. And the more you think about it, the funnier it gets. And the funnier it gets, the more you think about it. And it just becomes absolutely hilarious that you could smell this bad and they get blamed for it. It is absolutely funny. Then you realize something else. You've got a gas bubble. You've got a big old gas bubble. And then you think, you know what, it doesn't matter because the other guy's getting blamed for it. So you just lift your leg and let it fly. And that just becomes even funnier because you get to let that go and somebody else gets blamed for it. Oh man, it doesn't get any better than that. All right, everything's back to normal. Everything's back to normal. No more smelly, no more stinky, no more funny. Everything's back to normal. And 1, 2, 3, wide awake.
All right.
What is going on? We're trying to do a show, and you guys are laying all over the floor. went down on the
land.
All right, let's everybody find a chair.
Now, those of you in the chairs, the thing you realize is you are not in a chair in the building. You realize that you are sitting in the seat of a brand new car. You are sitting in the seat of a brand new car. So everybody, keeping your eyes closed, go ahead and sit up in your chair. Everybody keeping your eyes closed, sit up in your chair. You realize you are in a brand new car. And this isn't just any car. Your parents are treating you right. Congratulations, they bought you a brand new Camaro. You've got a brand new Camaro for graduation. That is a nice car. Go ahead and reach up and fill the gas. Reach up and fill the gas. Oh, isn't that nice? That is such a nice dash. Reach over and feel that steering wheel. Feel that steering wheel. Man, it feels like it was made for your hands. Well, then you notice the keys are in the ignition. Reach down and start that bad boy up. Reach down and start that bad boy up. Start that car up. There you go. Oh, man. Is that awesome or what? Go ahead and back that thing out of the driveway. Back it out of the driveway. Watch out for the garbage can. Watch out for the garbage can. That's a brand new Camaro. All right. Go ahead and rev it up. Give it some gas and go. Oh, yeah. Feel the power. Oh, man. You don't have to worry about anything tonight. The cops are all at the donut shop. No tickets will be given tonight. Cops are in the donut shop. Open that thing up. See how fast it'll go. You're going 80 miles an hour. 80 miles an hour. That's right. That thing is cruising. Holy cow. You got a hard right. Hard right. Straighten it out. Straighten it out. Give it more gas. 140 miles an hour. You have no driver's license, no life, no registration, and no insurance, but it doesn't matter. The cops are at the donut shop. Hard left, hard left. Hard left. Straighten it out, straighten it out. Oh no, there's a cop. Don't stop. If he catches you, you are going to jail. If he catches you, you are going to jail. Straighten it out. Straighten it out. Give him more gas. You got to ditch him. 190 miles an hour. You ditched him. You're going to come up. You're going to take a hard right. You're going to skip to a stop. Get down in your seat. You don't want to find it. If he catches you, you are going to jail. If he catches you, you are going to jail. Oh, my goodness. This is so scary. This is so scary because you have no driver's license, no registration, no proof of insurance. Don't let him catch you. When you hear this music, the cop has found you and you are in so much trouble. And I am the cop. So everybody, 1, 2, 3, eyes open, sitting up in the seats of your car, sitting up in the seats of your car. Looking around, don't let that cop catch you. Don't let that cop catch you. Do you know how fast you were going?
No.
Just come clean. It'll go easy for you.
Okay.
How fast were you going?
I'm 80.
In the school zone to boot. Do you have your driver's license, registration, proof of insurance?
Yes. I do.
Did you steal the car? Is that why you're going so fast?
No.
Wow. What should I do here? I mean, by law, I should take you to jail, but what should
please,
I do here?
Please don't. My mom will be so mad. Jack, come get me. She'll be so
they say. Don't do the crime if you can't do the time.
Please, please.
Drive innocent in your car. Let me call this in and see what they want me to do.
What? You?
Be honest with me. How fast were you going?
You've been drinking too!
Have you been drinking tonight? I had you 170 on radar.
Take his breath!
I need to see your driver's license, registration proof, and insurance.
I don't have it.
You have no driver's license?
I don't even know who I am anymore.
Did you steal the car? Is that why you're trying to outrun me?
I don't know. I was over in it.
Where did you get the car?
The silly.
Who?
The silly.
The who?
The silly.
Oh, the silly. The ceiling gave you the car.
Are they going to be up?
Yeah.
You sure?
They always do.
Okay, you better call them. Tell them you're going to jail. Then he can come pick you up.
How much is the bail?
What?
How much is the bail?
How much is the bail? Well, the judge will have to set that.
Oh my God.
Tell them the law. Hypnotist law enforcement. Hypnotist law enforcement.
I did it again.
Tell her where you're at. You're the...
I don't know where you're at! There's a tracking device on my phone. You know where
I am. Let me see. Mom, this is the hypnotist, so I want you to be too worried. Oh, you are? Hi. There. I don't know where your mom is. No, she said to take you to jail.
Here's the thing, is you really, really, really want to play with this toy. However, you will share, you pass it down to the person next to you so everybody can experience this toy. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Set up your chairs, which I brought with me tonight. Yes, it's very cool, isn't it? I got this at Walmart. Yeah, on the package it said, be very careful, because it's a hypnotist toy. Anything I tell this thing to do, it does. Yeah. But watch, I can tell it like to be a shaky toy, it's shake, 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 shake. Okay, you want to try it? Okay, it's a shaky toy. Pass it down. Pass it to the person next to you. Go ahead, pass it to the next person. Pass it to the next person. Pass it to the person next to you. Pass it to the next person. Here's the deal. It's the happy toy! Yeah, it makes you happy! It makes you so... So... It's so... Yeah! Alright, pass it down. It's the happy toy! Yes, that's right. Pass it down, pass it down. There you go. Okay, it's a happy toy.
It is. Celebrity, the person that you admire the most. Yes, I can see that on your face right now. Okay, when I shake your hand like this, you fall in love with that person next to you. That very person next to you, you fall in love with. And when I shake your hand like this, you fall in love with the person next to you. However, be clean, wholesome love. So no kissing and no inappropriate actions or anything like that. When I shake your hand like this, you speak perfect Chinese. You understand English? You speak perfect Chinese. Everything you say will be in perfect Chinese. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Open your eyes, sit up in your chairs. All right, can we just have you slide in? Just one slot, one chair. Okay, we've brought all these people that are now our stars of the show. We need to take some time and really introduce you because you've been doing so well. They're so excited to have you here. How are you doing? It's nice to see you. And what is your name?
Cicely.
Cicely, nice to meet you. I'm glad you could make it. I'm really glad you could make it. You don't look that impressed to have me here. I guess not. It's nice to meet you. How are you? And your name is?
Quinn Terrell.
Is what?
Quinn Terrell.
Quinn Terrell. Sure nice to meet you tonight. Yeah. Okay. And it's really cool. Yeah, it's good. So, are you happy to be here? Yeah? Yeah, it's great. Okay.
You look identical to me. Everybody, 1, 2, 3, eyes open.
How's everybody feeling? How's everybody doing?
Good. Hey, bro. You look good.
You look good.
Oh, dude. I like you.
I like you.
I don't like you.
How do you do it? It's like looking in a mirror, isn't it? I'm just going to talk to the audience for a minute, okay? I'm just going to talk to the audience. Yeah. I'm just going to talk to the audience. So as I talk to the audience, your focus goes to my right hand. And you realize there's something different about my right hand. It's white, pasty, lifeless. Realizing that you look identical to me, you begin to notice that your hand looks the same. White, pasty, lifeless. You see that starting to move up your arm. All through your body. Feeling your vocal cords beginning to lock. You realize earlier you were bitten by a zombie. The transformation is happening. You are becoming a zombie. You want to scream out, but you can't because your vocal cords are locked.
Oh, I think I was there. I think.
All you can do is moan because the transformation is complete. You are a zombie. Feeling your eyes fixating. You stare at the audience. Feeling your arms going straight out in front of you. Arms going straight out in front of you. Now you can't bite them, scratch them, you can't do anything to them physically, but you can get in their face and hiss and growl. Because you want the human brain. Feeling yourself rise up in your chair. You want the human brain. You cannot do them anything to them physically. All you can do is hiss and growl in their face. Zombies live to dance.
in black foot tonight.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
I can't hit him, Logan.
No, because that we're expanding the box. All right. Did he shoot himself or did he shoot? Okay, the first time touch. Okay, you know what's interesting? Rex, go ahead and have a seat right here. Okay. Go ahead and have a seat right here. No, you're okay. He was faking it. Okay. All right. Holster your hypno guns. Holster your hypno guns. Okay. Holster your hypno guns. All right. Dusty. Rex. You're Rex. Go ahead and stand right there. You need to stand. Wait. Come right here with me. Yeah. Go ahead. Come right here. Dusty, go. Okay. All right. So here's what happens. Okay. Go ahead. Go ahead. No. Go ahead. No. Right here. Right here. Stand right there. Right there. Stand right there. All right. We're going to have a hypno shootout. Now there are rules to the hypno shootout. I'm going to count from 1 to 3, and on the number 3, you will draw your hypno gun and you will shoot each other with a sleep bullet. Holster that. There you go. When I count to 3, on the number 3, then you can All right. Now here's the deal. When you fire that sleep bullet, it travels in slow motion. You can see it coming, but you can't dodge it. Dusty, are you ready? Or Popeye, are you ready? Yes, you can be Dusty. Dusty, are you ready? You better give him your game face. Give him your game face. Make sure he knows you mean business. Alright, get that spinach down you, Popeye. Alright, 1, 2, 3. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. We had a great time.
Have a prosperous year this year.
My brother Doug
and my brother Don.
Thank you. Thank you.